Hey guys, it's Chika. 皆さんこんにちは、チカです。So believe it or not, this is my 1000th video on the channel. 実は今日はバイリンガル英会話のチャンネルの1000本目の動画なんです。It is spring now, the cherry blossoms are bloom, so I thought I would film it outside to mark a new chapter of my life. And yes, I've got hair all over my face. So I've been doing this for over a decade now. As you guys know, I celebrated my 10-year anniversary on YouTube last year. And now we're celebrating 1,000 videos. I thought about what I wanted to do for this special day.I found myself thinking a little too much about it, and I was like, it's just another video, just upload something. But it's not every day you get a chance to really think about something and mark a new chapter. So even if it did take me a little longer to upload this video, I wanted to take the time to deeply think about where I am, where I want to go, and what I wanted to share with you.7 years ago, I wrote a letter to myself in a video called Dear Me. But this time, it's a Dear You. I decided to write you a letter. 今日は皆さんへお手紙を書かせていただきました。最後まで聞いていただけたら嬉しいです。Alright, so here goes. Dear my friend watching this video right now. First, I just want to say thank you.I've shared a lot of me with you over the years. You bared with me in the beginning as I got acquainted with myself on camera. You laughed with me as I tested my creativity, experimenting with new videos. You sympathized with me when I lost confidence. You explored the world with me as we opened ourselves up to new cultures and perspectives. You were both nervous and excited for me during my biggest challenges.You cried with me during the most eventful moments of my life. You waited for me patiently when I needed time and space and encouraged me to believe in myself. You reached out to me even when we didn't agree. And because of you, I've managed to continue doing this for over a decade. So today I am dedicating my 1000th video to you. I want this video to be about the future. The next 1000 videos we'll be sharing together.But to start talking about the future, first, I feel we have some catching up to do. These 2 years have been a challenge for all of us, dealing with a global pandemic and living life within it. We've had to make huge adjustments to our life, to our everyday routines. COVID has kept us from exploring. It has kept us apart from loved ones. It has made us feel alone, scared, paranoid,frustrated, the list goes on. It has forced us to make difficult decisions. It has tested our friendships and relationships. Life is difficult as it is, and COVID has made it so much harder. As you know, we had a rough start to the pandemic with our decision to return to Japan from abroad. We closed down our comment section due to some of the hate and threats that we received. But as I disconnected myself from the hate,I feel like I disconnected myself from all of you. Not just because we no longer could see your comments on our videos, but the entire experience made me feel voiceless as I struggled between gray lines of what was okay and what was not. Even though in reality, there is no answer. The experience instilled a constant worry and uncertainty in me. After 4 months of taking time and space to myself, we were back uploading videos again.But my relationship with YouTube and with you hasn't felt quite the same. I became more and more emotionally detached as the pandemic lingered on. Traveling and creating travel content was my passion. It energized me. It's what fueled my desire to share. It had become my life work. I've tried to stay positive and have been making the best of our time in pause. Videos with Pudding have been so much fun to make.I love documenting her growth and will continue to create family content as her and Clover grow up together. But my recent videos have been so much about me as Pudding and Clover's mom, and very little about me as Chika. My thoughts, my emotions, all the things that I'm going through as I face the challenges of life. A lot of you message me telling me what a good mom I am, or applaud me on how creative I am with the kids. Some of you tell me you want to be like me when you have kids of your own. As happy and flattered as I am to receive such compliments, I know in my heart what you see in my videos is just part of the story. And there are so many days when I don't live up to the expectations. I just haven't been able to share that side of me because I've been too scared of what other people might think. Because I'm not confident, I feel so incapable these days, trying to juggle everything and failing most of the time. There isn't a day that goes by that I'm happy with myself or feel like I've done enough. I'm always wishing I could have done more, wishing I could have been a better mom, a better me. Because I haven't shared my true feelings and emotions with you, I think you get the impression that I'm all smiles and life comes easy to me. Some of you tell me how much you respect me for balancing work and life. And with so much emphasis on women and all that they're capable of these days, I do feel like I have to set an example, not letting you see me fail, that I have to prove that it can be done, when in fact, I feel like it's impossible. But this is not who I want to be or who I want to portray on this channel. What I feel I have created with you on this channel over the years is friendship. And friendship should be more than picturesque moments and nicely edited experiences. It should be about sympathizing, understanding, and encouraging through the sharing of not just the happy moments, but all the other moments that make life, life. I want to be more open. I want to be more real, more raw. I want to be more genuinely me. Me is messy. Me is stressed out. Me is constantly struggling. But at the end of the day, I'm doing my best to get through life and to enjoy life, just like all of you. And that's what really inspires people, to know that you're not the only one, to know that it's hard for everyone, to know that life is chaotic, but that's what makes it beautiful. You just need to take it one step at a time and live it the best way we can. So with that said, I'm ready to open up, be more me again, show more of me, and not be scared or afraid or paranoid or think too much about what people are gonna think, and just believe in myself. I talked about believing in myself in the video that I returned to YouTube with, but I don't think I was there yet. I think time and your continued support has helped me get to this point.
本当にこの2年間コロナで皆さんも大変な思いをされていると思います。どのように影響されたとか影響の度合いは人それぞれ違いますが、動けない、何が正しいのか何が正しくないのか、周りとの感覚の違いだったり、考え方の違いっていうのもすごくあからさまに出てくるような状況だったと思いますし、今までに感じたことがなかった感情とか、今までに想像していなかったことを想像するようになったりとか、本当にいろいろと考えさせられる2年間だったと思います。で、まあ、この2年間があったからこそ生まれてきているものもたくさんあるし、何でもなるべくポジティブに捉えて、新しいやり方、新しい生き方をクリエイティブに生み出していかないといけないなっていうのを改めて感じました。でもやっぱりこのコロナの影響で、私たちの場合は炎上もあって、その後のこのチャンネルの私の中での存在と皆さんとの距離感っていうのはすごく大きく変わってしまったなと思います。復活して動画もたくさんアップはしているんですけれど、なんか自分がきちんと出せてなかったりとか、出したくないと思ったりとか、なんか不安だったりっていうのがずっと続いていました。でもやっと、まあ、コロナもそろそろ終わりそうかなってちょっと前向きになれたり、まあ、春になって桜もこうやって咲いてて、まあ、気分もテンションも上がってきたり、あと、まあ、これまでずっと私がこうやってちょっと距離を置いていたにも限らず、メッセージを送ってくださった皆さん、コメントいつも書いてくださった皆さんの応援があったからこそ、もう自分を取り戻そうって思うところまで来れました。もう本当にもういろいろともうオープンにシェアして、なんだろう、もうもっとストレートに、もっとリアルにいろいろ 発信していきたいなと思っています。
I'm just ready to get this channel back and be me again and not just the pretty clips of my life here and there but what I'm feeling and what I'm thinking and even just the little things in life. There are so many things that I want to doI think we're all hoping COVID is finally nearing the end. I mean, you never know what's going to happen. There have been so many times we felt like we were able to spread our wings and fly, only to find our wings get clipped again. And I think we've reached a point where we just have to decide. The pandemic, COVID is nothing to take lightly, but I think in other places, people are learning to move on and deal with life with it.And that's what I'm going to do. That's what our family's going to do. We're going to learn to deal with it. We're going to start traveling. We're going to start exploring. We just have to take necessary measures and do things differently than before. But I think we really just need to take that step, and everyone needs to take that step to get our lives back. I think there's so much that we can share by our travels with our family experiencing.Different things, different cultures, different perspectives all over the world. And that really is my passion. So I just cannot wait to start traveling again. And now it's not just for myself and Osaru-san, but for our kids. I mean, there's no better way to educate your kids than to show them the world. So I'm extremely excited to take Pudding and Clover everywhere. And we are just gonna have an adventure and learn so much.And just broaden our horizons and bring it all back and share our experience with you to give you inspiration and to give you new ideas and a new outlook on life or a new way to live. So a lot of traveling coming your way, it might be a little bit different the way we do it as our kids grow older, but we will be traveling. I want to do another American road trip with the kids this time and just see how different that is and the new world that they show us. With Pudding, I am learning firsthand the potential of kids, children learning languages. So definitely new projects concerning kids and English education. I want to continue doing fun English learning content, not just through videos, but other apps.And the metaverse. Don't even get me started on the metaverse because I'm really into it right now. I will save that for another video, but I just feel like there's so much potential with this new technology. And I think that with education, the possibilities are endless. I could go on and on. So the future is bright, full of hope and full of ideas. It's going to be chaotic. It's going to be messy, very unorganized and a struggle.Now that I have two kids, it is so hard to juggle everything and to find time to get things done. I feel the need more than ever to work with people and to trust people to make a lot of the things that I imagine in my head come to life. Right now, I am in the middle of growing a community. We want more and more of you to join us. We're trying to build things together, start a new culture in a sense, and just be more open.To new ideas and to new ways of doing things.
クリエイターの自分としてはもっとこういう作品作りたいとかもっとこだわりたいとかっていう思いもあるんですけれど、まあ、今子育てというライフステージでなかなかワークとライフのバランスを取るのが難しく、もう本当に毎日悩んでます。まあ、でもその中でもやれるやり方で、新しいやり方でやっていけるかどうかが大事で、いろんなことを考えていますが、あまり考えすぎずもっとフランクに気軽に発信者としての自分をもっともっと成長させていきたいなと思っています。
I tend to not share these ideas and my thoughts with you for some reason, especially the last few years. I've just been closed, but I'm just gonna open it up and see what happens. You'll probably see me talking a lot more about my projects, and I hope that you guys will knowSupport me as you have, and I hope you feel excited for everything that's going to be coming because you're a huge part of it. This video marks the beginning kind of a new me, of a new era on this channel, and I am very excited. And to start off this new chapter, I am going to be doing a live stream. I'm going to open it up to questions that you guys have for me. I have not done a live stream in 3 years.So if you want to send me questions via the message form, I'll post something on Instagram where you can write in your questions as well. So be on the lookout for that. Thank you so much for listening. I had a lot to tell you. I had a lot to share with you because we hadn't taken us time. And I hope you guys feel like you've reconnected with me a bit. I am back and I am ready to take you on a new journey with me. So I hope you're ready. Come drink with me. Come here.
おどんぐりいっぱい取ってきたの。そろそろママの自分に戻らないといけないんですけれど、最近は働くママもね多くなってきて、皆さんバランスで苦戦していると思うんですけれど、一個一個いろんなことを形にしていけたらと思っています。
Alright guys, thank you so much for watching、to the next 1000 videos. Aren't you tired of the drama? You use your words like they are knives、I don't need that type of drama And trying to be tough all the daytime You try to make yourself feel better by taking me down Once I fell, but now I'm strong, I'm ready for the rematchLooking at me so cold. Get over yourself. Are you for real? Why are you looking at me so cold? One's love is now our enemies. You try to make yourself feel better by taking me down. Once I fell, but now I'm strong. I'm ready for the rematch.
Let's get started!